Now we will have a look at analysis on single stage impulse turbine. The single stage impulse turbine or any other steam turbine can be analyzed by using a method called velocity diagram. For each and every problem, for each and every turbine, if you need to analyze it, we need to draw steam, we need to draw velocity triangles. Now in the figure you can see I have considered a single blade here, okay. For that single blade, I have considered inlet velocity triangle and outlet velocity triangle. So drawing of these velocity triangle at inlet and outlet will be very essential in order to solve any kind of problems. Now let us understand the terms which are involved in velocity triangles. So among that V1 is the absolute velocity of the steam at inlet. Okay, you can see here V1, it is the this line represents the absolute velocity of the steam at inlet of the blade. And next one, alpha 1, okay, you can observe here alpha 1. Alpha 1 is the inlet angle made by this V1, which means absolute velocity, or we can also call it as nozzle angle, or in other words inlet guide vane angle. Okay, this is alpha 1. Now VR1, this is VR1, I forgot to mention here, but this is VR1. VR1 is the relative velocity of the steam at inlet. Okay, relative velocity of the steam at inlet. Now beta 1, okay, this angle is beta 1. The inlet blade angle, this beta 1, we can call it as inlet blade angle or inlet rotor angle or moving vane angle, or in another words, angle made by relative velocity is called at inlet is called beta 1. Now U represents the tangential velocity of the rotor. Now VU1, here this VU1 is the tangential component of this absolute velocity. Okay, this VU1 is the tangential component of this absolute velocity, or we can also call it as VU1 as virl velocity. Now VF1, here it is, VF1 is radial component of this Vn is called VF1. VU1 is tangential component of this absolute velocity, and VF1 is radial component of this absolute velocity V1, and this VF1 can also be called as flow velocity at inlet. This is about inlet. Similarly for outlet, whatever the term you have mentioned here is, here is nothing but it is at outlet. Same term will be at outlet. For example, V1 is the absolute velocity of the steam at inlet, and similarly V2 is absolute velocity of the steam at outlet. So like that we can name. And this is the combined velocity triangle. Okay, in earlier slide we have seen inlet and outlet triangles differently, I mean separately, but here I have combined both the inlet and outlet velocity triangle, or inlet or outlet triangles, and we can see this combined velocity triangle. This combined velocity triangle is very useful to solve the problem. Okay, for every problem we will try to draw this combined velocity triangle itself. Okay, you can observe here U is tangential speed of the rotor, VU1 is the absolute velocity at inlet, and this is VUT is the absolute velocity at outlet, VR1 relative velocity at inlet, VR2 relative velocity at outlet, VF1 it is radial component of absolute velocity at inlet, VF2 radial component of absolute velocity at outlet, VU1 it is tangential component of absolute velocity at inlet, VU2 tangential velocity of absolute velocity at outlet. This is what the combined velocity triangle looks like.